We'll get started. If you guys are coming in late, we can you can catch this on YouTube. I'll upload it right away. I titled this Periscope. Five mistakes that are hurting my trading. This comes from an idea that I got off Twitter. One of the clients that I've worked with through my training course was writing some Twitter posts. We have a great community on Twitter, so if you guys are over there, go ahead and follow me. Same handle as Periscope, at Akil Stokes RTM, but follow me on Twitter. We have a great community, lots of support for traders. But he posted things. He said, "Akil, looking over my mistakes, I found out why I'm not profitable." And then he went on to list the reasons why he's not profitable. So I'm going to run through the list with you. And this is from a real trader. He says, "One, I've been trying to trade both trend continuation and counter trend trading." Meaning there are basically two ways you can trade the markets. You can trade with the trend is your friend, or you can trade against the trend. We're not going to get into what is better, what is worse. They both have their pros and cons. People say you want to be with the trend because when the market trends, it expands further than what it does when it retraces. However, the market is also only trending 30% of the time, which means 70% of the time it's in a counter trend or some type of consolidation, I should say, which lends itself towards counter trend opportunities. So you can be very profitable doing both. You can be very unprofitable doing both. It doesn't matter. But what I advise the traders that I work with when they first start off is pick one way. Tell yourself, I'm either going to be a trend continuation trader or I'm going to be a counter trend trader, and focus on one until you get a little bit more experience. And I say that because you're going to get, if you try to do both like this trader is doing, you're going to get conflicting signals. There's going to be some point in the market, again, if you catch the trend, you know, imagine the market's going up, you got an outside return, right? Let's say you're buying it on outside return right here, and you're buying it in anticipation of the higher trend. At some point, you're going to retest previous structure resistance. At that retest of previous structure resistance, that's often going to be a counter trend trading opportunity. And if you're a trader that has both, if you don't have clear rules and filters for when to do one and when not to do one, guess what? You're going to get to that situation where you're like, oh my God, I'm in a trend continuation trade, got to hold for the breakout. Oh, double top, got to sell. Hold of resistance. And then you wind up making some type of emotional decision. Sometimes you're right, sometimes you're wrong. The key is you lose that consistency. So it's always hard to do both trend trading and counter trend trading at first until you have enough experience to really add those filters and determine when is the right side to be on the market. If you're new, welcome. We're going over the five mistakes that a trader of mine or a client of mine has five mistakes that's hurting his profitability. I'm going to put this on YouTube later in case you guys caught or missed the beginning. The second one. He says, trading outside of my plan. So essentially what this trader was doing was, simple enough, wasn't following his trading plan. We have our trading plan for a reason. It takes a lot of work to develop and construct that trading plan. But once we've gone through that work, that basically is our business plan. That's what's supposed to keep us consistent in the market. So essentially it's like not following directions. So if you're not following directions, it's going to be very, very hard to expect to get the results that you desire. The next one would be the wrong position size. That speaks for itself, right? Trading the wrong position size. It could be detrimental to your trading account, especially when you start taking losses. Why? Because when you lose, you're losing more than you're supposed to lose, which means your account is going south quicker. More emotions get stirred up. When more emotions get stirred up, you start taking trades you're not supposed to take, trying to get revenge, or you stop taking trades that you're supposed to take because of some type of fear. The next one is not reading my trading plan. That's actually kind of essentially, or the trader said not reading my plan before each trading day. I know a ritual that I used to do just to get in the zone a little bit, get fired up before each trading day is I would sit there. I had my trading plan in a one of those spiral binders, and I'd sit there and I'd read the whole thing. I'd read from top to bottom. Took me about, you know, maybe 5 minutes, and after doing that, I'd be fired up. I thought of it as like my coach giving me a pregame speech, and I guess this trader said he stopped doing that and therefore kind of wasn't really mentally prepared to trade going into each day. The last one, number five, using entry reasons that I'm not supposed to. So the trader was entering trades probably too early. So seeing trades, for example, this trader may be for a buying opportunity, he's supposed to wait for a conservative buying opportunity like a double bottom. And instead of waiting for that double bottom and that confirmation, which is going to keep him out of certain, you know, false breakouts and stuff like that, or false signals, getting emotional, taking the trade because it looks good, it feels good, I don't want to miss it, and then having the trade break out and looking back and saying, man, I really shouldn't have been in that in the first place. So these are five mistakes that the trader was making, and I responded to him. I said, hey, essentially, it's great that you're recognizing these mistakes. Now you have to do something about it. And in trading, you know, addition by subtraction is often one of the quickest ways to flip your trading around, meaning that it's not, a lot of traders think that when things aren't going their way, they have to jump to the next system. They've got to take more trades. They've got to add this. They've got to do that. Sometimes it's the exact opposite approach. You know, sometimes you have to look at what you're doing wrong and just get rid of those things. And as a result, your trading will improve. You know, I'm a big sports guy. I'm watching the Raptors Heat in the background. It's halftime right now. And I was thinking of the football days and sometimes how as a coach or as a player, you have to adjust to the situation at hand in a football game. Sometimes it's okay to take those shots downfield. You know, Arizona Cardinals, Carson Palmer, deep balls all the time. But sometimes you find yourself in a situation where the markets are like they are this year. They've been bad, guys. Right? Would you guys agree? Give me some hearts. The markets have been bad. We've touched on this in a few of my past videos. They've been unpredictable. There hasn't been the movement that we usually expect. It's been a very difficult year to trade. And I think about that as like one of those football games where the defenses on both teams are just controlling the game. You know, it's a defensive matchup. And when you're in that defensive matchup, the key isn't to score as many points as possible. The key is to not make that crucial mistake. You need that quarterback that's going to make the right decision. It may not be the glorious big bomb down the field that scores you the touchdown and everyone goes wild, but you don't want to make those mistakes that hurt your team. You don't want to make a turnover in the red zone and have the other team score. And I apologize if you guys aren't football fans. But addition by subtraction, sometimes the best thing to do is be conservative, try to eliminate those mistakes. And as a process, by eliminating those losses, you'll actually become more profitable because you're not giving stuff back to the market. So wanted to give you guys a quick scope on that since I've been out of town for a little bit. I appreciate you guys that are new, that are joining me. Hey, if you find yourself in that position where you feel like you're struggling, you're having these mental challenges, you know, follow us on Twitter, guys. We have a great community over here at Trade Empower. We've got myself, Jason Greystone, Charles Miles. They're very active on Twitter, just talking to traders, you know, basically keeping them in a positive environment as they go into the trading week. And of course, we have other stuff like live rooms that you can check out. We have free weeks in a London live room and New York live room and all types of stuff you can sign up for. But be a part of a community, guys. Surround yourself by like-minded individuals, people and traders that when you're having a bad day, instead of knocking you down and making you feel worse about it, they're going to lend you a helping hand, lend you some advice and get you back on that positive track. So hopefully you can do what you need to do to be a consistently profitable trader. So hope you guys enjoyed this. If you're over on YouTube, subscribe. I'm going to get back to watching Jason Greystone's video. He just uploaded about a 33-minute video going over some trades he took in his London live room. So I'm going to finish that off. But wanted to give you guys a quick scope while the game's at half. And I'll see you guys Monday for our Q&A, 12-weekers. The rest of you guys, I will see you. I'll see many of you in the live room on Tuesday through Friday. The rest of you guys, I'll see you next time I upload a video to YouTube. Until then, plan your trade your plan. Just YouTube search Akil Stokes. Akil Stokes, YouTube search Jason Greystone, Charles Miles, Jason Stapleton. We've all got YouTube pages. You can go to our website as well, www.tradeempower.com. We've got more free videos and more free content than you have time to watch. Let's just put it like that. But I always say watch at least the last five videos, get a feel for the message that we're spreading across. We have many videos on technical analysis, many videos on trading psychology, and it gives you a good feel of just our philosophy on trading. Yes, you can YouTube search that, check it out. But take care, guys. Hope you enjoy the rest of your weekend. For you guys where it's still Sunday, and best of luck this trading week.